let's discuss the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in the Buddhist scriptures. Almost all the Buddhist scriptures, they speak about a Maitri to come. It's also mentioned in Chikka Varsuna Sitanta, D111-76. It says that another Buddha will come by the name of Maitri, the Holy One, the Supreme One, the Enlightened One, endowed with wisdom and conduct, auspicious, having knowledge of the universe. Whatever he will get from supernatural knowledge, he will preach to the whole world. He will preach a religion which will be glorious at the beginning, glorious at the climax, and glorious at the end. He will preach a way of life which will be truthful and wholly perfect. He will have several thousands of monks, as I have several hundreds of monks. This prophecy is also repeated in the sacred books of the East, volume 35, page number 225, that a Maitri will come with such and such criteria and qualities. And further it says that he will be a leader of thousands of people, as I am a leader of hundreds of people. It further mentioned in the Gospel of Buddha, page number 217 and 18, that Ananda, he asks Buddha that, O Blessed One, after you have gone, who will guide us? So the Blessed One Buddha, he replied, that I am not the first Buddha in this world, neither am I the last. There will be another Buddha who will come, the Holy One, the Supreme One, the Enlightened One, endowed with wisdom and conduct, the auspicious, having knowledge of the universe. He will preach a good religion. He will preach a religion which will be glorious at the beginning, glorious at the climax, and glorious at the end. He will teach a religion which will be based on truth and will be a perfect way of life. And he will have many thousands of disciples, as I have only hundreds of disciples. The Ananda asks Buddha, the Blessed One, how will we know him? So Buddha replies, he will be called as Maitri. Maitri means the merciful, loving, kind, compassionate. One equivalent Arabic word is Rahmah. And Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 107, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We have sent thee not but as a mercy to all the worlds, as a mercy to all the creatures, as a mercy to the whole of humanity. This word Rahmah, mercy, and its derivatives are mentioned in the Quran no less than 409 times. And every chapter of the Quran, except for Surah Tawbah, chapter number 9, begins with the beautiful formula, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, most gracious, most merciful. So the Buddhist scriptures, almost all of them, prophesies about the Maitri that is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to come. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is further prophesied in the Buddhist scriptures, which is mentioned in the sacred books of the East, volume number 11, page number 36. Mahaparinibbana Sutta, chapter number 2, verse number 32, it says that as for the Buddha, there are no exoteric or esoteric teachers. And O Ananda, the Tathagatas, that means the teachers, have nothing like a closed fist. We cannot keep the knowledge to ourselves. It should be proclaimed. And we know Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whatever he received as a wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he proclaimed to the whole of humanity. And he told his disciples that never keep it away from humankind. Proclaim it and spread it. That's what's mentioned in the prophecy. There's nothing like esoteric or exoteric. Everything should be told to the humankind. It's further mentioned in the Buddhist scriptures, in the sacred books of the East, volume number 11, page number 97, Mahaparinibbana Sutta, chapter number 5, verse number 36. It says that as Buddha had a servito by the name of Ananda, so shall the Maitri have a servito. And we know from history, from the seerah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the servito of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Anas, may Allah be pleased with him. Nadilla one. was the son of Malik, may Allah please with him. And Hazrat Anas, may Allah please with him, he says that my parents gave me to the Prophet at the age of 8. And his mother told the Prophet, O Messenger of Allah, take this to be your servant. And Anas, may Allah please with him, he said that the Prophet referred to him as his son or the little beloved one. And we know Hazrat Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, he always stood by the Prophet in times of peace and in times of war, in times of safety, in times of danger. He can very well be compared to Ananda. We know when the mad elephant rushes at Buddha, Ananda stood by Buddha. Similarly, we know Hazrat Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, in the battle of Uhud, at the age of 11, even when the enemies were close to Prophet Muhammad, Hazrat Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, stood by the Prophet. Even in the battle of Hunain, at the age of 16, when the enemies who were archers surrounded the Prophet, yet Hazrat Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, he stood by the Prophet. He can very well be compared like Ananda when the mad elephant rushes at Buddha and Ananda stays by Buddha. So this is the fulfillment of the prophecy that the Maitri will have a servitor. It is further mentioned in the Gospel of Buddha, page number 214, that this Maitri to come, this other Buddha to come, will have 6 qualities. The first is, he will get enlightenment at night. Number 2, he will become bright when he gets enlightened. Number 3, he will die a natural death. Number 4, he will die at night. Number 5, when he dies, he'll become bright. And number 6, once he dies, he will never be seen in the bodily form in this earth again. These 6 qualities and criteria befit no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad. We know that Muhammad, the first wahi he got was at night time. As I mentioned earlier, the Quran says in Surah Dukhan, chapter 44, verse number 2 and 3, and Surah Qadr, chapter 97, verse number 1, that the Quran was revealed in the night of power. It further says, he will be lit up. And we know Muhammad had become bright. He was enlightened. It further says, he will die a natural death. And we know Muhammad had a natural death. Point number 4, he will die at night. And we know from the hadith of Hazrat Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, that she did not have oil in the lamp. So she borrowed the oil from the neighbor, indicating it was night when Prophet Muhammad died. It further says that he will become bright at the time of death. And Hazrat Anas, may Allah be pleased with him, says that Prophet Muhammad looked bright when he died. And the last point is that when he dies, he will never be seen in the bodily form on this earth. I know Muhammad, when he died in the bodily form, he's buried in Medina, and he was never seen in bodily form again. All these criteria mentioned in the Buddhist scriptures befit no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad. It's further mentioned in the Buddhist scriptures, in the sacred books of the East, volume number 10, page number 68. It says that the Tathagatas, they are only preachers. That means the Buddha has to come. They can only preach. And Allah says in the Quran in Surah Ghashiyah, chapter number 88, verse number 21, Fazakkir innama anta muzakkir. Allah says to the Prophet, your job is to deliver the message. Giving hidayah is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's further mentioned in sacred books of the East, volume number 10, page number 67, that to go to paradise, even your good deeds are responsible. Your good deeds are responsible for you to go to paradise. And Allah says in Surah Al-Asr, chapter number 103, verse number 1-3, Wal Asr, innal insana fi khusr, illa ladhin amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. Which means, by the token of time, man is very in a state of loss, except those who have faith, those who have righteous deed, those who exhort people to truth, and those who exhort people to patience and perseverance. One of the criteria to go to Jannah is amal salihat, righteous deed, which is mentioned in the Buddhist scriptures. And further, it's mentioned in Dhammapada, Mattaya Sutta, 151. It gives the criteria of the Buddha, the final Maitri to come. It says that he will be a mercy to humankind. He will be gentle. He will be an example to humankind. He says he'll be kind. And he will be truthful. So all these criteria befit no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad. This was in brief regarding Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Buddhist scriptures.